Hello everyone, today we learn about Bacillus anthracis. It affects animals. So humans, how they get infected is through contact with an infected animal or by inhaling the spores. So these spores, they're very, very tiny. You cannot see them with your naked eye. And thus, it's used as a bioterrorism agent. People who work in an abattoir or a slaughterhouse, they usually get this. Now this bacilli, it looks like bamboo sticks and gram staining. Look at that. In culture, in agar, you'll see frosted glass appearance. So frosted glasses, they are translucent glass that you see in offices and sometimes in clinics. So that's how, look at this, it looks translucent, right? So frosted glass appearance in agar. On gelatin slab, what do you see? Inverted fir tree appearance. Yeah, look at that fir tree appearance. It also shows Medusa head appearance. So Medusa is a Greek goddess. She is supposed to have snakes around her head, which looks like her hair. So look at that. In culture, you'll see this. It looks like hair. It also, you'll see a string of pearls reaction. This is in the presence of penicillin. What happens is these cells, they become larger and round. And they occur in chains. So it looks like strings of pearls. It shows cutlass appearance in transmitted light. This is how a cutlass looks like. So it's something like this you'll see in transmitted light. Next is McFadden reaction. This is very important because when you stain the bacilli with polychrome methylene blue, for a few seconds under the microscope, you'll see a purplish color material around the bacilli. Now, this purplish color is actually the capsule, which is a characteristic of anthrax. So, that is also a presumptive diagnosis, used as a presumptive diagnosis. Selective media is PLET media. You guys should know what is PLET media, what are the things under it. And Ascoli's thermoprecipitation test, it is done for demonstration of this anthrax antigen in tissue extract. Toxins are capsule, which we already talked about, and the anthrax toxin. And it's a gram-positive bacilli. And it is spore forming. Usually spore forming bacilli are motile, but this is an exception. This one is non-motile and it is a strict aerobe. It needs oxygen. It is capsulated. That means it has a capsule around them and it is that capsule is the virulence factor. It shows weak or absent hemolysis. Now, these are the various forms, okay, in which anthrax appears in humans. First is the cutaneous form. Cutaneous means skin. And this cutaneous anthrax is also called as the hide-porter's disease. Hide means leather. And porter is someone who carries something. So people who used to carry leather from one place to the other, they used to get this malignant pustule, which later becomes a black eschar. Look at that left side picture. You'll see the malignant pustule and which around which you'll see a black eschar. But it generally resolves spontaneously and it's a painless lesion. So this is the most common form. Second is the pulmonary anthrax. This is also called the wool sorter's disease. Wool is from sheep. So people who sort the wool, they get this through inhalation of the spores. Third is intestinal. This is a very rare form. And treatment is using penicillin and other antibiotics.
That's all for today. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe to my channel and please leave a comment and let me know which topic I should do next. Thank you.